Okay, now let us reverse how we tackle these ones, but please don't forget to subscribe to the channel. We are going to see how we handle more of the triangle, angles in the triangle. So please don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Now, when I have this, is that I want this, but I have this. This one is the easiest. So we know, you see that B plus 40 plus 80, those are angles of the triangle, they will add up to 180. So RB plus 120 degrees, B 180 degrees. Take this side, your B will be minus 120 degrees, and your B is going to be 60 degrees. So my B is already 60 here. Now, if this is 80, means that this one is going to be 100. And if this is 40, 140, this one is going to be 40 because the angles on the straight line. So mean that now also A plus 40 degrees plus 100, they add up to 180 degrees. So this is A degrees plus 140 equaling to 180 degrees. Take this side, my A will be 180 minus 140, and my A becomes 40 degrees. When we come to this one, we start these two are parallels, meaning that this and this become corresponding angles because this one is going to become a transversal. Meaning from here, now 5y plus 55 is equal to 22y plus 100. The reason these are corresponding angles. If they are corresponding angles, now I write like terms. I bring this side, I'll be having 5y minus 2y, correct like terms, minus 55. This will be 3y, on the subtract I think you get 45. And if you divide through by 3, your y comes 15. So your y is 15. So meaning, if my y is 15, the whole of this angle is going to be. So this is going to be, I'm going to put 15 there. So I have 5 times 15, then plus. So meaning that the whole of this angle is 130 degrees. The whole of this is 130 degrees. Now, if it's 130 degrees, it means the balance here is going to be 50 degrees. If the balance is 50 degrees, why? Because these angles lie. I mean these two are angles on a straight line. So mean that I have this, now I have this, I have this, I can get now x. How? X plus now 53 degrees plus 90 degrees are adding up to 180 because this is a triangle. So my x now plus, this is going to be 140 degrees equaling to 180 degrees. Take it outside, your x will be 40 degrees. As simple as that, if you subtract this from this. Now, we have this one. Look, how are we going to handle this? Which idea are we going to use here? Okay, the first idea you see that this one is vertically opposite angles, meaning that this one is also going to be 35 degrees. And if this is 35 degrees, it means that it's going to be now alternating. So this is alternating, meaning that even this one is going to be 35 degrees. Meaning that now, my x by 35, they are adding up to 180 because their angles on the straight line. So my x will be 180 minus 35, and so my x is going to be 145 degrees. As simple as that. Now, how am I going to handle y? Okay, if I have, okay, if this one is 90 and this one is 35, it means the balance is going to be. Because the whole of this is going to be 90, so this is going to be, the balance is going to be 90 because this is a straight line. Meaning, this is 35, this one is going to be 45 degrees. So if this is not 55 degrees, not 45, this one is going to be 55 degrees. How am I getting it? Because if this is 90, it means that the balance is going to be 90. So 35 minus 90, you get 5 degrees. Now, so that now this one and this one is So you see that this arrow and this one, they are not being on interior. Mean that my y plus 55 degrees is equal to 180 degrees. The reason here is all interior angles. So mean that my y is going to be 180 minus 55. So your y is going to be 130. It's going to be it's going to be 125. So this one is going to be 125 degrees with ease. Okay. Now we are 125. So you see when you add this one, you get 180. So now what I'm going to use here. So here I have this x, I want to get that with and y. So start from here, my x, I can just get x because x plus 72 plus 58, I get 180. So this one is going to be x plus, when you add this one, I think you get 130, equal to 180, taking this side, that your x is going to be 50 degrees. When you take it and subtract. After getting x, come and get y also. So that from here, my y plus 40 plus 60 is 180. So y plus 100 is equal to 180. Is that how y is going to be 80 degrees. Okay. After getting y, I need w. But you know that these are opposite. But these are vertically opposite angles. So this is going to be x and this is going to be y. And you see that now, my x plus y plus w is going to be 180 because now this is a triangle. Now it's that you have x plus 80 the y. Then our x is 50. Then plus rw equaling to 180. So when you add it here, you get 130 degrees plus w equaling to 180 degrees. And it's that your w is going to be 50 degrees with ease. And let's remember the equation, so I think we can go with this one. Okay, what are we going to use here? There are many properties we can use. I want to get y and I want to get x. So see that these are called interior angles, meaning that y plus 100 degrees are equal to 180 degrees or 80 angles. Now, mean that from here, my y is going to be 180 minus 130, my y is going to be 50 degrees. Or in here because there are angles for the transverse. Now, if this is 50, it means that this one is going to be also 50 degrees. Why? Because these are vertically opposite angles. And if this one is 60, this one is also going to be 60 degrees. And from there is that our x plus 50 degrees plus 60 degrees, we add up to 180 degrees. Because now this is a triangle. And since this is x plus 110 equal to 180 degrees, my x becomes 70 degrees. And so, members, unless you have a question about angles, you can send more and I try them for you. I wish you the best.